difficult to even talk about or even say out loud. Feels kind of surreal. And the news that I have for the fans and yeah, for the world is I will be leaving Chelsea at the end of the season. Yeah, it's been an unbelievable time, best time of my life. It's been 6 unbelievable years, together with my teammates, together with the fans and the club in general, and I feel so privileged to have been on this journey with the club, because we really established ourselves as one of the best clubs in the world, and it's been such an amazing journey. So I feel I'm not only sad, although it might look like it. I'm also really, really happy and just proud of the whole journey and everything we've been through together. It's mixed emotions for sure.
All pictures and the medal from the first, from my first season at the club. So this is the WSL league title medal, and this is when we won the FA Cup, and this is when we won the league. All your firsts were always really, really special. I will never forget this season because you see I look like a little baby, so really young at the time. First time abroad, first season at a new club in a new country, and I feel like I kind of came home straight away as I joined the club. Felt really welcome from the start. The girls were really, really nice to me, especially Hedvig. So you can see Hedvig Lindahl in the middle here. She made me feel at home straight away. She explained how everything worked. She was my safe space in the beginning, and that really helped. So I think it was my third season at the club when Emma pulled me into her office, and I didn't know what she was going to ask me, but we didn't have a captain that pre-season because our previous captain, Karen Carney, had just retired. So I think Emma wanted the summer and the pre-season to like reflect on what she really wanted to do with the team. Yeah, she just asked me if I could come and see her one morning. She just pretty much sat me down and asked me if I would want to be the captain of the team, and for me it came completely out of the blue. It was something I didn't expect her to ask me that, so I was in shock. I wasn't that old at the time, I wasn't super experienced. I'm obviously from Sweden, so I was in English, and I thought that I never in a million years thought that she would ask me for that, but as soon as she asked me, I felt incredibly honored. I mean, it's not something that you would turn down, so I was extremely happy that Emma would trust me with such a big responsibility. So she asked me to be the captain of Chelsea. 3 days later we played the opening game at Stamford Bridge, first time I've ever played at Stamford Bridge. It was also on my birthday, so you can imagine I was quite nervous at the time. I don't think I've ever been so nervous before a game. I mean, it was just a game in the league, but it felt so special to me. Yeah, being the captain of this team has been the biggest honor of my life. Then another chapter in the Chelsea career, when Pernilla joined. I think for me it's like, as a footballer you give up so much because you move away from your family, you move away from your friends, to live this kind of lonely life as a professional football player, but you get to experience so much. But for me, when Pernilla joined, I kind of felt like, okay, now I get to get the best of both worlds, really. I get to be at a club that I love, I get to play the game that I love, but I also get to have close family nearby and have someone that I will share all the joys with and share the whole experience with. Also, success off the pitch, our fight for the LGBTQ community, stuff that we wouldn't have been able to do if we weren't living together. That's another part of the Chelsea chapter that I'm really proud of, that we got to to spend three seasons together and achieve so much together. This one is very special to me as well, because this is one of the fans. So her name is Hannah, which you can see here. She has made this flag, and she is a massive Chelsea fan. She is, yeah, she rarely misses any game really, and she's such a true supporter. And I think the flag is very, very, very nice, because it represents a lot that like women's football stand for. And I think it just says a lot about the Chelsea fans as well. Like, the fans mean everything to us, like literally everything, and I think they are, yeah, such a huge part of the club, and I'm going to miss them so much, because they truly are the best fans in the world. They follow us up and down the country, across Europe as well, when we play in the Champions League. They have an endless support for us in good times and bad times, and I feel like all the things we've achieved across the years, we've achieved together with them, because we have such a tight bond. So yeah, that's, I'm truly gonna miss the atmosphere at King's Meadow and the atmosphere of playing in front of our fans. So this is, obviously it's not a gold medal, which we had hoped it to be, but this is still a special medal for me, because it was my first Champions League final. It was the first Champions League final that Chelsea women has got to. I don't think it will be the last, but it will be my first and only Champions League final with the club. I think the fact that we managed to get to that final was a massive statement for the club, where the club is heading. I think after that season, the club know that, okay, we're not gonna go back now, we're gonna keep pushing for new boundaries. And it's been very inspiring to be part of a club that's constantly been moving in the right direction and constantly improved every season. This thing is something that Emma, our manager, before every big game we play, so before every final, she always gives us a little gift or a little message or just something to kind of celebrate the occasion. It's definitely one of the reasons why we've been so successful. The cup medal from this season. So happy that we won the game. The occasion was unbelievable. Playing in front of a sold-out Wembley, playing in front of so many Chelsea fans. Truly, like, as soon as the whistle blew, I got tears in my eyes, and I could just feel like the joy that of the things that we've been through and the things that we've achieved as a club. All my Chelsea fans, teammates. We've created like a really tight bond with some of the girls, and these are a couple of them. When you live abroad and you're away from your real family, you can always create a second family, and I think this group of people has been my second family, as I've been at this club. It meant so much to me, and they've been my security and my safety net. We've took turns supported each other throughout the years and throughout the seasons. These are people that I will never forget. I think they will be my friends for life.